In the middle of a lost valley, there is a lake with pristine, calm waters. And in the middle of that lake lies a small island covered in trees and great rocks. A peaceful lull breathes throughout the valley with kind winds, a bright blue sky, and a plentiful stirring of animals big and small. But suddenly that peacefulness is broken. A great howl pierces throughout the valley, causing absolute chaos. The startled animals rush away in fright. The winds turn into a gale. The sky turns black with clouds, and the lake shakes with anger. Following the howl, the sound of chains thundering against rock echoes throughout the valley. If one were brave enough to venture to the middle of the island, they would find a gigantic beast struggling to break free of his bonds. They would find the most famous wolf in all of mythology, Fenrir, the monstrous Norse wolf. Fenrir's first appearance in Norse mythology and written history is in the Poetic Edda, compiled in the 13th century, with the poems likely dating even further back to oral traditions. It is in the poem Völuspá where Fenrir is prophesied to kill the king of the gods, Odin, during the end-of-the-world battle known as Ragnarok. Fenrir also shows up in Snorri Sturluson's Prose Edda, another important source of the Norse stories. In it, Fenrir is one of the three children of Loki and the giantess Angrboda. With Fenrir's brother Jormungandr and his sister Hel, the three grow up in Jotunheim, the land of the giants. But once Odin found their location, he decided to get rid of the children of Loki, for they were prophesied to be his enemies in the Battle of Ragnarok. So he banished Jormungandr to the Earth's ocean, and Hel to the land of the dead, Niflheim. But for Fenrir, he decided to keep him as a pet in Asgard, the home of the gods. He then entrusted Tyr, the god of war and law, to keep an eye on Fenrir. As time passed, Fenrir grew larger and larger, and as he continued to grow, the gods grew more wary each day. Dreading the prophecy, the gods formed a plan to bind the giant wolf using a fetter. So twice the gods tried binding Fenrir with the shackles known as Læding and Dromi. They tricked Fenrir by telling him his strength and name would become famous if he could break such bindings. And so both times Fenrir prevailed and snapped the bindings into two. Fearing that their plan would never work, Odin sent a messenger to the dwarves. In that message, Odin asked the dwarves to build shackles so strong that even the strongest god couldn't escape. And so the dwarves gathered five sacred ingredients: the roots of a mountain, the spittle of a bird, the beard of a woman, the sound of a cat's footfall, and the sinew of a bear. And with those, they crafted the shackles Gleipnir. And even though it looked to be made of silk, it was the strongest bind of Norse mythology. So the gods brought Fenrir to the island Lyngvi and challenged him to break Gleipnir. But Fenrir suspected trickery when he looked at the shackles, and so told the gods he would only let them put Gleipnir on him if one of them stuck their hand between his jaws. That way, if he couldn't break Gleipnir, then the gods would be forced to let him go, or bye-bye to the hand. None of the gods moved, for they knew what would happen, and right as they were about to give up, Tyr stepped forward and put his hand in Fenrir's mouth. Accepting Tyr's hand, Fenrir allowed the gods to place Gleipnir on him. And Gleipnir proved its worth and name, for Fenrir was not able to break the binding. Seeing that he had been tricked, he bit off Tyr's hand while the gods laughed. The gods then looped Gleipnir around the great rock Gul, and then stabbed Fenrir through the mouth, keeping his jaws eternally open. There they left him, and there Fenrir stayed until the time of Ragnarok. It's important to note that in the time either before or during Fenrir's binding, he mated with an unnamed troll woman who gave birth to his sons Skoll and Hati, the wolves who eternally chase the sun and the moon. Skoll and Hati play a very important role in the beginning of Ragnarok by finally catching and swallowing the god of the moon and the goddess of the sun. Then the stars disappear and the earth begins to shake, causing all binds to snap, including Gleipnir. Free at last, Fenrir, with his eyes and nostrils spilling with flames, charges throughout the Nine Realms. With his lower jaw against the ground and his upper jaw in the sky, Fenrir devours every single thing in sight. Fenrir then heads towards the field of Vigrir, where the Battle of Ragnarok is taking place. There he faces Odin in battle, and after a long fight, Fenrir swallows Odin whole, only to suddenly be attacked by Odin's son, Vidar. Vidar kicks Fenrir's lower jaw and then rips Fenrir's upper jaw from his mouth with one hand, finally killing the Great Wolf. While Fenrir caused so much destruction and killed Odin during Ragnarok, I can't help but think it was justified for the horrible treatment Fenrir experienced. Perhaps if Odin and the gods didn't give in to the prophecy and bind Fenrir, then he wouldn't have been an enemy in the final battle. Either way, Fenrir is an important figure in Norse mythology, symbolizing vengeance, strength, and destiny. I would even argue that Fenrir is the most impressive wolf in all of mythology. Hey, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like and subscribe. I have more videos on Norse mythology and other mythologies on the way, so don't miss out. Until next time on Wild Mythology.